what we're talking about, right? If you've lost the press, you've lost Kirsten, who has been a supporter.
If you've lost Kirsten Pelosi, you've lost America?
That's it.
All right. You're in the Walter Cronkite belt. But now there is a dissenting voice at MSNBC, Ed Schultz, who often takes on the media, does not like the coverage, and I guess even at his own network. Let's take a look at that.
The mainstream media, I believe, wants Obamacare to fail. They're afraid to do a positive story because they're afraid that somebody might not watch. The media is just cherry-picking the bad facts that are out there, repeating them over and over again, and in many cases, they're making stuff up.
Bad facts, making stuff up.
What? What did he just say? I'm sorry. It didn't make any sense. The media has been so upbeat on this until the website crashed, until it was learned that the promises were broken. And on the negative facts, hello, there are more negative facts than there are positive.
Right. I mean, there are some positive stories to be told because this rollout is helping some people, but it's so totally overwhelmed by those who have been either can't get on, can't get the policies, or it will cost them more money if they do get new policies. But what about the fix that the president announced, the proposed fix to allow these, quote, substandard plans to continue to be sold for another year?
Right.
Why has that not changed the coverage at all?
That was fascinating that it was such a reversal of the president's position. And immediately after he made that announcement, you saw criticism from the media instantaneously. Does the president even have the legal authority to, rescind these cancellations? So you're seeing a media critique of the president that is instantaneous in a way that we haven't seen for 5 years.
I want to pick up with you, Kirsten, your point about journalists feeling led astray, betrayed, let down, they're angry. And of course, you've had some personal experience there because you've lost your health insurance plan as a result of this new policy. So does that extend to you? Are you personally disappointed in the president? And how much does that color what you write and say about him?
Well, I've been personally disappointed, I think, as you know, many times with the president, over the years. So yes, it's disappointing when he says something that's not true. And I'm not that concerned about my personal situation. I actually have said this before. I can afford it. I'm willing to pay more for more people to have insurance if that's in fact what's
going
to happen.
But it certainly hits home.
But it's, well,
when you see it firsthand.
It hits home, but it's more that I just know for a fact that what they're saying is not true. So a perfect example is they continue to claim that, oh, well, we're just saving people from substandard plans, which was never the purpose of Obamacare. Let's just stipulate that. But we're saving people from substandard plans. My plan is not substandard. All the things that they say that people like me don't have in their plans, I have. So I guess it's helped me be able to know, well, wait, I'm one of these people, and what they're saying isn't true, and they need to come clean and stop making up all these reasons for why people are being kicked off their health insurance.
Now, other presidents in modern history have lost the confidence of the public and also lost the benefit of that with the press.
Well, of course, take President Bush with Katrina. He seemed out of it. He was looking from a helicopter down on this ravaged nation. Bill Clinton, who had an affair, and his popularity didn't tumble that much. But
why was that?
It's because he didn't hurt the millions of people and their pocketbooks. What he did was something personal that wasn't very acceptable.
Right, but Obamacare obviously affects just about everybody in the country, whether you're keeping your health insurance or not. It is not some theoretical Washington scandal. Interesting moment on Megyn Kelly's show where Zeke Emanuel, former White House aide, brother of Rahm, who helped design this health care system that is not working very well right now, took a shot at this network. Let's take a look at that.
Remember, this was not an environment which was hospitable to setting up the exchanges.
I know.
You and your colleagues were constantly criticizing, trying to underfund it,
trying to make sure it didn't work. I don't think Fox News had anything to do with the rollout of healthcare.gov.
You were constantly attacking the law, and you were trying to make it underfunded.
It was all our fault.
Okay.
Let me ask.
I watched that interview, and Mr. Emanuel is doing Obamacare no favors with this completely wild, absurd, ridiculously on its face untrue spin.
Well, he can push back against Fox, where there has been a lot of negative analysis of this law.
There's been negative coverage, but as Megyn Kelly pointed out, Fox News had nothing to do with the rollout of healthcare.gov.
So blaming the messenger,
this
perhaps?
This is absurd, and getting back to Kirsten's point, with all of this spin that can be, is demonstrably false, we have 5 million cancellations. That's 5 million stories. We only have 27,000 enrollments through healthcare.gov. So the media can go, you don't have to go very far to find people who've been negatively affected, who've had their policies canceled, who don't get to see their doctors, don't get to go to the same hospitals. And this is a story that's just going to keep rolling.
And yet, in the face of all this, we have these New York Times editorials. First, it was one that said that Obama misspoke when he promised you can keep your plan. And then it was described as an inaccurate promise. What kind of Orwellian language is this?
It's pathetic. I mean, it's really, this is completely pathetic, and I don't even know how they can write the things that they write sometimes on that editorial page, because they're, I mean, go to the New York Magazine. They put together, not exactly a conservative outlet, they put together end-to-end of every single time he said it, 20-plus times or whatever. I mean, this was something that not only he said, but now you have, you know, they're now rounding up every Senate Democrat who said it. Democrats all across the country were going out and saying this and promising this and believed it.
Right. Well, before we go,